Hello, I am Dr. Aizaz from MedicoVisual.com. So in the previous lecture, we had discussed that how this laryngotracheal diverticulum arise, and from this laryngotracheal diverticulum, two primary bronchial buds, they arise. So right primary bronchial bud and left primary bronchial bud. So these primary bronchial buds then form the right primary bronchus. So this will form the right primary bronchus, and this will form the left primary bronchus. So this will go into the right lung, and this will go into the left lung. Then from this primary bronchus, at the right side, three secondary bronchi arise, and two secondary bronchi, they arise on the left side. So three secondary bronchi on the right and two secondary bronchi on the left side. And by the way, these secondary bronchi, they are also called lobar bronchi. Why so? Because each of these lobar bronchi, they are going to supply a single lobe of lung. So naturally, it means that because here there are three lobar bronchi, it means that there are three lobes of this right lung. So one, two, and three. So three lobes of this right lung and two lobes for this left lung. We do not know the precise reason for this. One hypothesis of this is that on the left side of your mediastinum, there is your heart. So the left lung has a less lobe as compared to the right lung. So this might be a reason for less number of lobes of the left lung. So let's see how these lobes are present here. So here you can see that right lung, it has three lobe. Upper lobe, this is the upper lobe, this is the middle lobe, and this is the inferior or lower lobe. So each of the lobe is supplied by its lobar bronchi or secondary bronchus. So upper secondary bronchus, middle secondary bronchus, and lower secondary bronchus, right? So similar to that, on the left lung also we have two secondary bronchi, upper and lower, and there is no middle bronchus because we have only two lobes. Then what happens next is that these secondary bronchi, they further subdivide into tertiary bronchi. So first we have primary, then we have secondary bronchi, and then another generation of subdivision leads to formation of tertiary bronchi. So here we have several different tertiary bronchi, and these tertiary bronchi, they are also called segmental bronchi. Why they are called segmental bronchi? Because they supply each bronchopulmonary segment of your lung. So we have about 10 bronchopulmonary segment of right lung and 10 on the left lung. So here are these bronchopulmonary segments. So you can see that upper lobe, this is the upper lobe, and upper lobe is further subdivided into three segments. Similarly, middle lobe is subdivided into two segments, and the lower lobe, it is also divided into I think four or five bronchopulmonary segments. So what are and similar is the case here, there is no middle lobe, but superior and inferior lobe, it has been divided into two subdivisions. Now the question is that what are bronchopulmonary segments? Bronchopulmonary segments are isolated structural and functional units of the lung. What it means is that if we remove let's say this bronchopulmonary segment, the other bronchopulmonary segment of the lung, they will continue to function independently, right? They will continue to perform their function normally independent of the other bronchopulmonary segment. So each of the bronchopulmonary segments, they are independent workers. They do not rely on the other bronchopulmonary segments. So what are, anatomists, they are quite fussy about the names of these bronchopulmonary segments, and they want you to remember the names of these bronchopulmonary segments in a proper sequence. So let's say this is the first bronchopulmonary segment and it is called apical bronchopulmonary segment. So these anatomists, they quite often ask you these segments in exam. And it is quite difficult to memorize that. But you know, Dr. Aizaz is here to help you. So let's memorize these bronchopulmonary segments by using a funny mnemonic. And what is the mnemonic? The mnemonic is that a perverted advocate loves meddling with small pussies. Oh, I know that mnemonic might be offensive for some of you people, but that will help you remember this. So let's remember with this mnemonic. So this is the first bronchopulmonary segment of the right lung, and that is called apical bronchopulmonary segment. And you can remember it from the A of the mnemonic. So a perverted advocate. So from that A, you can remember that the first bronchopulmonary segment of right lung is apical. And then this is the second one. This one is the second one. And second word of the mnemonic is perverted. So this is the posterior. So apical and posterior. Of course, these are named according to their position. So here you can see that it is placed posteriorly, so that is posterior, and it is forming the apex of right lung, so that is apical bronchopulmonary segment. Then are perverted, so apical posterior, and the third one is a perverted advocate. So advocate, A for interior, so this is interior one. And this is the third bronchopulmonary segment of right lung. So then what's next in the mnemonic? A perverted advocate loves meddling. So from L of loves, there is this lateral lobe, that is fourth segment. So fourth bronchopulmonary segment is called lateral bronchopulmonary segment, and that is actually the part of middle lobe of right lung. So loves, then meddling, M for meddling, and M for medial lobe, that is the fifth lobe. So medial, not lobe, again and again I am saying lobe, please don't get confused, sorry for that. This is fifth bronchopulmonary segment. So fifth bronchopulmonary segment is medial segment. So apical bronchopulmonary segment, posterior segment, anterior segment, lateral segment, and medial segment. First three are the part of upper lobe, then fourth and fifth, they are the part of middle lobe, and from sixth onward, they are the part of the inferior lobe or lower lobe. So let's move forward. So small pussies. So S of small stands for superior bronchopulmonary segment, that is the sixth segment of right lung. So superior bronchopulmonary segment. So after superior, then there is SMAL. So M stands for medial segment. So here is the medial segment, and that is the seventh segment. So that is seventh segment, that is medial segment. Then SMAL. So this one is the anterior one, and this is the eighth. So anterior segment, SMA, and then there is ninth one, that is lateral segment. So this is the lateral segment of right lung, and then finally there is the 10th segment, which is the most posterior, and that is posterior basal. So actually from all these segments, from here up to here, from 7th up to 10th, these are the basal segment. So this is medial basal segment, this is anterior basal segment, lateral basal segment, and posterior basal segments. Now the names of the segments of left lung, they are quite similar, except we do not have the middle lobe. So what, how can you remember their names? So we can slightly change the mnemonic for this. What we can say is that a perverted advocate, he does not love meddling. So what we can say is that a perverted advocate sucks intensely small pussies. So for upperverted advocate, again there is apical lobe. First is the apical lobe, then second is posterior lobe, then anterior lobe. Again, no, this is your revision. And then we do not have that loves meddling. Now we have sucks intensely. So fourth is the sucks, I mean superior, and fifth is the inferior. So superior segment and inferior segment, and then again rest are the same. What is this? Then there is sixth, superior segment of lower lobe. This was the superior segment of upper lobe. And by the way, these two, they are also called linguella. So this fourth one is the superior segment of linguella, and the sixth here is the sixth one. So sixth one is the superior segment of lower lobe of left lung. Then rest are again the same. So seventh one here is the medial segment. Eighth one so this is the medial. Eighth one is the anterior. Then nine is the lateral, and 10th is the posterior basal segment. So medial basal, right, anterior basal, lateral basal, and posterior basal segment of left lung. So these were the bronchopulmonary segments of right as well as left lungs. And now you know precisely that how do they develop. That first there is formation of primary bronchi, then there is formation of secondary or lobar bronchi, and then there is formation of tertiary or segmental bronchi. And each of the segmental bronchi, it supplies a particular bronchopulmonary segment of the lung, and each bronchopulmonary segment is an independent structural as well as functional unit of your lung. So thank you so much for watching this.